Badat says, woohoo! Lodi says, let's meet again. Okay. Stella says, goodbye until we meet again. Oh my god. Chris says, goodbye. Yuya says, bye-bye. Everyone, take care. Goodbye, Chris says again. See you again, Yurio says. Oh my god, shut up. Yurio and Chris resume their journey home, seen off by many great friends. Parting was sad, but both of them were filled with the joys of finally heading back home after their pilgrimage. Yurio and Chris open the letter from Dirzel. Dirzel's letter. Dear Yurio and Chris, you guys fought well. You probably don't know what a great and noble thing you did, but you really did well. It's all thanks to you. I thank you from the bottom of my heart. If you two hadn't come to the Tower of Terufez, I'd probably not have done anything to try to stop the wave. I'm ashamed of myself. I know that the swordsman's rule is to live optimistically, no matter how dire the situation, and never give up. But when I realized what was happening, I turn into an old man who simply waits for the end. Some people refer to me as the model court swordsman, the hero of my generation, but that's all a misunderstanding. What I had become was just one of the castle officers, but with a sword. We had all forgotten our ways. And when we realized it, we were caught up in the bureaucracy, unable to see the forest for the trees. It's all over when that happens. I feel the heroes live with the people. And heroes aren't people who defend one person's will or who fight well in battles. Heroes are those who understand the weak in a pure way and who can always be optimistic. I think Gweld and you guys are more worthy to be referred to as heroes. Do not forget your adventure. Don't ever lose your soul of the hero. This is a world that you and Gweld saved. It's your duty to make sure that the world doesn't head into a wrong direction, because you are torchbearers for the next generation. Let me tell you a story. Read this like you're reading from a fairy tale. It was before I became a court swordsman. I was traveling, thinking that I was going through some warrior training because I wanted to become a swordsman. At that time, I heard about Ortega. Ortega, the great sorcerer, the sole survivor of the Witch's Island, the man who made the magic capital Oldos, left and went into retirement. I was always interested in Ortega. Of course, there are differences in people who handle spells and people who handle swords. But the way Ortega trained his skills are common to people who train under the sword. I was too intimidated to go see Ortega while he was in the Grand Cathedral, but if he retired, it's a different story. I talked to people to find out where he retired to and got to a village in the mountains. I met Ortega the Great Sorcerer. I was hot-blooded back then, but Ortega treated me kindly. I learned so much from Ortega. I don't know how much I used all that was taught to me, but I still considered Ortega the master of my will, even after I became a court swordsman. Many years have passed, and Isabel appeared in this world. Then Gweld appeared too. I told you about this before. When the Moonlight Witch was defeated, she left behind a single staff. I felt the staff contained Gweld's concerns about this world. After I buried Gweld, I took her staff and visited Ortega. When Ortega saw the staff, he was awed. The powers were well hidden, but the power inside the staff was something that surpassed the imagination. The staff contained the will of Gweld herself. A powerful staff is the same as a double-edged sword. Powers are referred to as curses, unless the right person uses the power at the right time. I decided to have Ortega be the keeper of the staff. Ortega used all the spells he could to seal the staff and change its shape, so its powers could not be used easily, and the staff ended up in Chris's hands. Ortega made it so that the staff releases its power atop the hill of Gweld, where Gweld's will remained when the dagger is near it. Ortega used up most of his magic to accomplish this. So now, I'm sure you understand why Chris's staff released such power. I wanted to tell you the story. In any case, you were able to complete your pilgrimage successfully. You saw many towns and met a countless number of people. But let me say this. What is important is how you understand all that you experienced and how you apply it in the future. No matter how many valuable experiences you have, it's meaningless unless you can apply it to your life. Keep your heart of the hero. Listen, grow up to be a good adult. I know it sounds like a lecture, forgive me. Just think of it as an old man's rant. This letter is too long. I agree. I should finish up. Lodi came by just now. He said that now that we saw you off, he wants to make his request to me, as I promised. Wait, now that we saw you off. So how do you give him the letter if the letter was written after they left? I already know what the young swordsman is thinking. I was like that once. I think the Esperancer that Yurio gave back to me will be of some use. Okay, you're rambling now. I have become old, but I don't like people making fun of me for trying to be young. I think it's a good time to retire. Take care of yourselves. If we see each other again, let's have a drink together. Dirizzle. This is a very long outro. Okay, here's Dirizzle and Lodi training. Dirizzle says, shall we begin? Don't hold your grudge if I win. Can you beat me, though? We'll see. Dirizzle says, it looks like you know how to adjust your timing. It's an honor to be complimented by you. Ha! Huh? You're pretty good, says Lodi. Oh, boy! He broke his sword! The sword broke, says Lodi. I guess we can't fight anymore. That sword is the Esperancer, isn't it? The name denotes hope, right?
Oh my god, we broke hope.
Yeah. Does this mean you lost hope? No, there is more than one hope. Even if one hope is lost, a new hope is born somewhere. Is your new hope Yurio and Chris? They are the hope of this world. For now, I guess my new hope is you. You got me on that one, says Lodi. P.S. Dear Yurio, a strong, sharp sword is not the only kind of useful sword. Sometimes a chip sword that seems like it's about to shatter can be the best sword you have. The same goes for this world. Says, Yurio, we're almost home. Basically, our home. I wonder if everyone is okay? Yurio says, I'm getting excited. I love the song. I wonder if Grandpa Lap is here. Oh, this is outside the village, right, right. Chris says, Grandpa Lap. I guess he's not here. Maybe he's over at the village. Yeah, that's probably it. Let's go. Chris says, that's funny. There's no one here. Well, just like in... what's his name's dreams? Yurio's dreams. I wonder where everyone went. Uh-oh, says Yurio. Huh? What do you mean, uh-oh? I had a dream at the Erosa Inn. A dream? What kind? It wasn't a very good dream. Don't hold out on me. Just tell me. You're getting me worried. Okay. I dreamt that we came back to the village. Grandpa Lap wasn't at his house, and everyone but Raj was gone from the village.
Raj was here?
Yeah, but he was on the ground.
Huh? Where?
Over here.
Oh, he dreamed this.
Huh? Says Yurio. Oh no, says Chris. Is the dream coming true? What happened after this?
I don't know.
Why not?
Someone woke me up.
Who's the punk who woke you up?
I think it was her.
You? Oh, really? Yeah. Raj isn't moving at all. Yurio? Why don't you go see if he's okay? Okay. Well? I don't know yet. Why don't you shake him? Okay. Yurio put his hands on Raj's shoulders and gave him a shake. Snore, snore, snore. Huh? Oh, she hitting him with the staff? Ouch, says Raj. What do you want? Who hit me on my head? Chris says, man, how confusing. Why are you sleeping here? Where are you? Who are you? Yo-Yo says he's still dreaming. Over here, Raj. Oh. Yo-Yo. Chris. You're back. Welcome back. Raj, we're home, says Yo-Yo. Hi, Raj. Where's everyone else from the village? And why are you sleeping here? Man, you have no idea. A messenger from Castle Rudo came and said you were on your way back, so I spent all night getting ready for the celebration. Huh? I was in charge of making the platform all by myself. I'm so tired. I'm sorry, Raj, says Chris. It's okay. The celebration is going to be at the West Fields. Everyone's waiting for you. Let's go. Luthay was a surprise party. I thought everyone was dead. Or went to, you know, another world, quote-unquote. Raj says, Yo-Yo and Chris are back. What's the other bard guy? Minstrel, whatever. Whoa, it's Tarova, says Chris. Yo-Yo says Tarova. Yeah, the Katara player, that's right. Hey, I happened to be in the area when I heard you were on your way back. I just had to greet you with my music. Yo-Yo says, oh, it's Grandpa Lap. Good work, kids. Is he gonna tell us some surprising twist secret? I'm really Morrison. Hey, Grandpa Lap, says Yo-Yo says. Say, Grandpa. Hmm? Gweld. The Moonlight Witch had to sacrifice her life to save the world, but was that really necessary? I wonder if she's regretting it at all? Well, her soul is gone, right? She's probably not even conscious of anything. Chris says, and she chose to be treated as a traitor by her own friends, right? I'm sure that was very hard for her. I guess so. But I don't think it was always hard on her. Let me ask you, how was your pilgrimage? The pilgrimage, says Yo-Yo? We didn't know what to expect at first, but it was really fun. Chris says, we met a bunch of people and made a lot of good memories. Yo-Yo says, we got into a lot of trouble, too. It was probably the same for her. People have this way of making hard times seem less serious. That's why if there is even one time that a person feels happy, Their whole life can seem like it was one big happy life. Even after you die, you walk the path that the Moonlight Witch left for you. I don't think Gweld is regretting anything. Yo-Yo says, Chris, we were way over there, beyond those mountains. Yeah. Menarth, Chenom, Ambish, Udar, Fenty, Gedona, and Oldos, we went to many towns and villages. Grandpa Lap says, the world is much bigger than the tiny part you saw. We know, says Yo-Yo. When we travel next, I hope we can go beyond the backbone of the Great Serpent, or beyond Gagarv. Chris says, if we have the chance, maybe we can even go to another world. I'd like to see the place where Gweld was born. Grandpa says, it looks like you really enjoyed traveling. Yo-Yo says, Grandpa Lap, you've been to another world, haven't you? Yeah. Why are you keeping it a secret that you're a really powerful person? Oh, so you figured that out, huh? Listen, Yo-Yo, Chris, it's no longer an age where a trained sorcerer can defeat evil dragons, or a strong swordsman can become a king with his sword. The world is not simple enough anymore to be controlled in such ways. Now, each one of us has to utilize our own skills to help everyone that lives in the place we call home. That's the only way. In order to do that, a legendary hero is nothing but a nuisance. From now on, we need the power that is rooted in the earth itself, just like Gweld's soul. Just like Gweld's soul. Long ago, a girl known as the Moonlight Witch traveled the land of Tirasweel, a visitor from another world. She walked alone on a journey of pilgrimage, sowing hope in her wake, near the end of the time when people believed that no land existed on the other side of the Gagarv or beyond the backbone of the great serpent Yuri and Christina left on a great voyage, some kind of voyage. The two young travelers walked the path of hope that the Moonlight Witch had left. The path was still there, 20 years after its making, when havoc ensued by the wave of Raiwal. Two worlds were saved by the pilgrims, each helped along their travels by the various people they met. This was in the Gagarv year of 992, when the people of Tirasweel were beginning to hear the harbinger of a new millennium. And that's it. The end. What do you guys think? Of the story, the game. It's not perfect. There's typos and bad grammar sometimes. But I really enjoyed it. Hope you guys enjoyed this journey with me. Next will be A Tear of a Million. I want to thank you guys for watching. See you guys in either A Tear of a Million or another Let's Play. Always seek adventure. girl known as the Moonlight Witch traveled the land of Tirasweel. The witch's name was Gweld. The road ends for none.